गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू आवर मैथ्स ऑनलाइन क्लास। सो वी आर गोइंग थ्रू द चैप्टर 4, बेसिक ज्योमेट्रिकल आइडियाज। विच आर द बेसिक आइडियाज यू हैव लर्न टिल नाउ? यू नो दैट पॉइंट्स, लाइंस, लाइन सेगमेंट्स, रेज, कर्व्स, ओपन कर्व, क्लोज्ड कर्व एंड पॉलीगन्स। इज इट? सो polygon is a simple closed curve made up of line segments. Only straight lines should be there in a polygon. That is the meaning. Next concept we are going to study, triangles and quadrilateral. From the word itself you know what are triangles. Tri means three. So for a triangle, three sides and three angles will be there. And in the case of quadrilateral, four sides will be there. Okay, so one thing is very important, you send the review test answers after the class. Some of you are not sending the answers. What is the problem there? Any difficulty to understand the matter? It is a simple topic, so you go through the notes and learn well. Okay, you can watch the class. Okay children, our today's topic is triangles and quadrilaterals. Triangle means it is a three-sided polygon. Tri means three. So triangle is the polygon with the least number of sides. Why? Because we can't design a polygon with two sides. Is it? With two sides we can't draw a polygon, because if it is two sides it will not be closed. So triangle is the polygon with the least number of sides. You understood? Triangle has three sides, therefore it has three angles also. Here AB, BC and AC are the three sides, and angle A, angle B and angle C are the three angles. Moreover, here you can see P is in the interior of the triangle, Q is on the triangle and R is an exterior point. Exterior point outside the triangle. Okay, so what do you mean by a triangle? Triangle is a three-sided polygon. What is a polygon? Polygon is a simple closed curve made up of straight lines or line segments. So here you can see only three line segments. So it is a simple closed polygon or simple closed curve, and it is called polygon. Three-sided polygon is called triangle. Okay. Here one question we can do. From the given figure, we have to identify three triangles. Which are the three triangles? Here ABD, this is small triangle. Next one, this is second triangle. Then the bigger triangle ABC. So which are the three triangles? Triangle ABD, triangle ADC and triangle ABC. Understood? Next question. From this figure we have to write the names of seven angles. Angles. What is an angle? Angle is a meeting point of two rays. Or angles are formed by intersecting two rays. Is it? Two rays. So this is the initial point of two rays here, which make an angle. Moreover, here D is an angle, C is an angle, A is an angle. Moreover, by the sides or rays we can represent the angles. Okay, so here how many angles we can write? ABD one angle, ADC second angle, A C D A D B like this, then CAD and CAB, because the arms are changing here, so another angle formed here. Then last one DAB. So these are the seven angles we can see from this triangle. Okay, next question. Write names of six line segments. Six line segments. How we will represent line segment? Using this simple. So we can see here line segments from here. AB is a line segment. AD, AC line segment. The next BD, DC. Moreover BC. So these are the line segments. Six line segments on this triangle. Okay. Next question. Which two triangles have angle B as common? Common means in both the triangles which angle will come again. Okay, so here which is the common angle here? So this angle B is common to this small triangle, and B is common to this bigger triangle ABC. So angle B is common to triangle ABD and triangle ABC. Okay. So what we have learned now about a triangle? Triangle is a three-sided polygon. It has three sides and three angles. Moreover, we can represent the points on its interior, exterior, and on the triangle. Next, we can learn the term quadrilateral. Now you learned three-sided polygon is a triangle. Next, what will be the four-sided polygon? Four-sided polygon is called quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means four-sided polygon. So it has four sides and four angles. Here I drawn a quadrilateral ABCD. You can identify four angles and four sides from this quadrilateral. Moreover, we can define the opposite sides, adjacent sides, opposite angles, and adjacent angles from this figure. Okay. Which are the adjacent sides? Means nearby sides, or which sides have common vertex? AB and BC have the common vertex B. So AB and BC are adjacent sides. Next one, BC and CD have a common vertex. So BC and CD are adjacent sides. CD and DA, next adjacent sides. Next pair is DA and AB. This is very simple to identify adjacent sides. Adjacent means nearby sides. Okay. Next we have to identify opposite sides. Which are the opposite sides? AB and CD are opposite. Okay. Moreover, BC and AD or CB and DA also opposite sides. Understood? Next one, opposite angles. In this figure you can see angle A and C are, angle A and angle C are opposite angles. Opposite angles because they have no common sides. But angle A and angle B are adjacent angles because there is a side AB. Okay, so this is adjacent angles, but these are opposite angles. Here B and D are opposite angles, and D and A adjacent angles, C and D adjacent, C and B also adjacent angles. You understood the difference between adjacent angles and opposite angles? Opposite, the concept of opposite direction. Opposite, here also opposite. Adjacent means they will be have a common side. Okay, they will be the endpoints of the side adjacent angles. Okay, so we can do one problem from this section now. Draw a rough sketch of a quadrilateral PQRS. Draw its diagonals. And we have to decide where will be its meeting point of these two diagonals. Here I draw the quadrilateral PQRS. What will be the diagonals? What do you mean by diagonal? Diagonal means the line segment joining the vertices which are not adjacent. That means the line segment joining here these two opposite vertices. Okay, diagonals. So this is a diagonal QS and PR also a diagonal. So you can see two diagonals for this quadrilateral. And where will be its meeting point? This is the point of intersection or meeting point. We learned point of intersection. Do you remember? So here this is the point or point of intersection or meeting point. Okay. So this meeting point of these two diagonals is inside the quadrilateral. That means this meeting point is an interior point. Okay. Understood the concept interior, exterior? Do you remember that? So here quadrilateral and its two diagonals. So now we learned which points, adjacent sides, adjacent angles, opposite angles and diagonals. Moreover, the meeting point of the diagonals of quadrilateral. So what is the three-sided polygon? Triangle. What is the name of the four-sided polygon? Quadrilateral. How many diagonals for a quadrilateral? Two diagonals. So we can conclude today. Revise the chapter well. This is a simple chapter, but if you don't know the concept, you can't understand the more. Okay, thank you, children.